Hello, Mark McLeod here at Spaceview, 127 Stewart Street, Dunedin, on the 19th of March 2018. My Fringe Festival show, How Did I Get Here, finished last week. I'm just doing one more video through the venue before I pack away the photographic material. Hopefully it will be of interest to someone. Handouts for people to find their way around the place. It's the Fringe Festival booklet. Work in progress. This one inspired by Arthur C. Clarke's Rendezvous with Rama. My version of it will have an asteroid hollowed out and an Earth-like interior on the spinning inside surface. Illustration from 1980s, Amiga magazine, Warhead. Fun piece of sci-fi for myself there. The Return, inspired by Forbidden Planet, the movie, Joan Crawford, and the Chrysler Building in New York. Bit of homoeroticism over here, Summer Dreaming in Dunedin. Kind of guy I'd like to look like. Bit of a background poster to that particular painting. Poster for the exhibition. In-house poster. Exhibition layout poster. A statement of why I support the Bodywork Skate Club here and why I'm giving up on the venue here. You can read that on Facebook if you want. Weights bench space, favourite piece of gym equipment. Exhibition poster, the timeline for my personal history. Again, that's on Facebook if you want to look. Painting from the 1980s, World Gathering. First illustration for a magazine, it was Amiga magazine. Short story called The Terrarium. That I saw in New Scientist magazine that inspired me, overlaid on one of my paintings from the 1980s. Me with that particular painting and a statement of my humanist values. Some of Stephen Hawking's words from the internet, downloaded the other day. Sad to lose Stephen Hawking, but he suffered a lot, so maybe not so sad for him. One of my favourite paintings, Arrival. Humanity being replaced by a new form of intelligence and consciousness. Companion piece is Millennium One. That new intelligence building its cities within a forested landscape in harmony with that forest. Canvas print of one of my paintings for Otago University. Poster of the railway station painting I did some years ago. Down the hallway here, a bit more homoeroticism. Gay romance, a Martian romance. And looking at the faces, we come back over here. You know, the poster of faces that have inspired me. Again, the kind of ideal that I wish I looked like. Some old sketches and paintings. Foundation principles, one of Well, I feel my more significant paintings, statement of my humanist values. Poster of New World Order, where I feared the world was going to back in the 1990s, and it certainly seems to be that case, fragmenting along tribalistic lines. We can't seem to get along away from our tribalistic sort of value systems. Served us well perhaps in millennia past, but not anymore. A couple of other paintings here. Cultural Terminus and Necrophilia in the 90s. Work in Progress, again this tribalistic issue. My People. In the end, all just controlled by these power mongers who manipulate our weaknesses to their own advantage. Work in Progress, comment on overpopulation, sunset on Canterbury. Turn an agricultural zone of the country into this super high density urban district, but still with some agricultural elements, as necessary would be necessary. Print on canvas, one of my rhododendrons. Magazine illustration for Amiga, UFO connection. Religious War was a comment on, once again, these power mongers hiding behind, in this case, a cloak of superstition to control us. In-house posters to get people to buy products. Limited success with that. Winter in St. Clair. Future of Dunedin after sea level rise. Posters of botanical and landscape paintings. Painting the man in his dreams, portraying my fears of where I'd end up, stuck in a city, as I seem to be, wishing I was in some utopian rural landscape. Yeah, to Stuart Street. Another poster of a botanical piece. Eco Defence, that was done in the 1980s for Simply Living magazine. Comet, inspired by Halley's Comet back in the 80s. Moment by moment, learning to let go, become less attached after a difficult relationship period. Down this little hallway, one of my challenging pieces of gym equipment, the pull-up bars. Artwork in Progress, thought I'd finished it many years ago. Liberation. A couple of incarnations, first as a sketch and a painting, and now I'm sort of wondering what form we would take as a species if we get to redesign ourselves, humanoid or something else. Landscape painting from my Alexandra period, beautiful autumn colours and rocky mountainous landscapes I loved. The goals for this venue, Space For You, unfortunately not supported by anyone else it seems, so it won't happen, and I've decided to move on, so that at least is the plan for 2018. Through here, Forest Walk, me with a painting back in the 1980s, I think that was at a Mardi Gras in Sydney exhibition. City in the Forest, it's been a common theme for me, the ideal of a high-tech city in harmony with nature. Another early sketches. Barbra Streisand, No Surprise, was one of my first paintings. Painting from my period at Iona, Eileen Caddy's Vision. And that was my period at Iona in the Central Tablelands of New South Wales. And Mandala, up in the Northern Rivers. Both of these places were quite important experiences for me back in the 1980s. Comet One, another painting inspired by Halley's Comet. Lunar Base and the Pharaoh's Airship, illustrations for Amiga magazine. Moons of Saturn was a second version of Lunar Base, produced for a woman who commissioned a number of these sorts of sci-fi pieces. She particularly loves Saturn, so Saturn got into a lot of them. And that was probably one of the best that I did for her. Mentor magazine, a little sci-fi fanzine out of the Blue Mountains. Used a couple of my art paintings as covers. Creeping floorboards. Influences Inspiration Room, Australia. New Zealand, of course. Images of my botanical interests on the screen there. Various movies. And books. Artwork from the 80s, inspired by a guy I was very intensely involved with at the time. The effects of aging on me. My thoughts on errors of judgment and perhaps positive experiences, positive choices. Down through here to the Queenstown period. Creaking floorboards. Old building. Yeah, posters of artwork that's all been sold, essentially, inspired by my time in Queenstown. I loved the region, not so much the town, which I think is continuing to degenerate into a cluttered mess. It's my utopian vision, inspired by Queenstown and North America. Backpacker series, bit of homoeroticism and based on the kind of image that I wish I looked like. And I think that just about is enough for this. So thanks to anyone who's watching. And goodbye for now.